Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with a look at the North American stock markets for Monday morning. In the pre-market on Monday, stock index futures are below fair value, so we are looking to see some selling at the open on Monday morning. Let's start off this morning looking at some weekly charts. And when I first look at my weekly charts, first thing I do is I scan through the panic zone charts, looking for new early warning signals up here. And there's none for the S&P 500. We are still projecting higher prices, but we have overhead resistance from last year that we still have to deal with. And so you can see that we're projecting up to 2200 right now, but 2125 is the level that held us back in 2015, and that is our next mathematical target. If we look back at the panic zone chart, 2200 is up here. You flip to the next chart, it is 2187.50. So 2187.50, 2200 is certainly a reasonable target to the upside if we can break through resistance. Our next mathematical target, as I mentioned, is 2125. That's the target we were trying to break through all of 2015 and couldn't do it. In fact, going into the end of the year, we had a run-up in the fall that took us up to 2116.48. That was our high. So we put in a lower high in November. And keep an eye on that, because we got 5 points away from that last week. So that is certainly a target, or a legitimate target to the upside before 2125. We did pull back and close below the 2100 level. So you've got mathematical targets. You also have psychological targets. And 2100 is a big round psychological target. Looking north of the border, we did have an early warning signal a couple of weeks ago. So far, we've been able to play through that. The pullback is a lot more evident on the daily charts and the weekly charts. Our next mathematical target to the upside is 14,375, then 15,000. And you can see up here we're projecting up to 15,000 on this chart. To get there, though, we have to get through some resistance. And the first level of resistance is our October high at 14,053. So we traded, we closed at 13,874. So we're a couple hundred points away from that area of resistance. And then 14,375. Those are our next two targets to the upside. Now, year to date, the TSX is up 6.6%. And we got in just below the start of the year price. You can see that in late February, we started to move up. There was the first week we closed above the upper channel line. So you bought at the open the next week. And we're up about 6.6% since that point. Now, the TSX had been on a sell signal most of 2015. Remember, we started to break down here in the spring and went through all of 2015 without being able to close. From that point on, we went through the rest of 2015 without being able to close above the upper channel line. And then finally, we did that at the end of February. Looking at the U.S., we're up 2.3% on the year, and we got in before that. So we're doing better than the year-to-date results for the S&P 500. We bought in right around 2,000 on the S&P 500 cash index, and so we've been able to move up just about 100 points since then. Since we're trading above the upper channel line, there's no reason to get overly concerned. Of course, you have your own individual price targets where you want to take money off the table. We won't talk about that here, but what I will talk about is when you've got something trading above the upper channel line, there's no reason to get overly concerned until you start seeing bearish reversal days and other early warning signals. When we get in the channel, of course, that is neutral, and the first close below the lower channel line would give us a sell signal, and we're certainly nowhere seeing that this Monday morning. Now, the big story in 2016, of course, has been the precious metals sector, and this is the XAU. XAU is up 78.5% year to date. Our returns are a little less than that on the weekly charts. Remember, we had to wait for the pop at the end of January, and then we got in at the open the next week, so we're doing pretty good. We'd have to abandon this sector on a weekly basis with a close below 63.41. We're not expecting to see that this week. We are expecting to see some weakness, but certainly not a major pullback that would show up on the weekly charts. Now, after I scan through the panic zone charts looking for new early warning signals, the next thing I do is I go to the chart pattern report. And last week we were talking about daily chart patterns, and now we're talking about weekly chart patterns. Of course, these are more significant because they're on the weekly chart. I don't look at every item in a report. I'm really only looking for the ETFs or the indexes or the stocks that are related to me that I follow. And there's a couple on here that I'm interested in following. There's the Junior Gold Index, which formed a bearish reversal bar, and there's the NASDAQ 100 ETF, the BMO NASDAQ 100 ETF, which also generated a bearish reversal bar. If we just look at the Junior Gold Index, you can see that there's our bearish reversal bar. You can see the last couple of times that we had bearish reversal bars, they actually marked the top in the move for this particular ETF at that time. And you can see there was a bullish one here that didn't work out. This one certainly did. And so it's a one bar event, and we're looking for two things to happen this week. Either we get fall through to the downside that will confirm that this is the top for this move in the market for this particular ETF, or we close above last week's high, and that would nullify that particular signal. Remember, the early warning signal on the panic zone chart is usually started by a trend, a change in direction for price over several weeks. Whereas this particular reversal signal, either bullish or bearish, is caused by 1 week's worth of price data. So they're both early warning signals, but they're both based on two different forms of analysis. Now, if we look at the U.S. market and divide it up by either indexes or ETFs, the one that's of interest to me on this one, we've got gambling, home construction, restaurants, airlines. And the airlines have had a nice run this year, and there's a bearish reversal signal for this particular index. You can see we had one a few weeks ago that didn't work out. We had a bullish one that certainly did, bullish one there that did, bearish one there that worked out. So they don't always work out. Again, they're one bar events that need to be confirmed, but they're certainly a warning signal that something may be happening. When we look at the ETF signals from last week, a couple of themes here as we go through them. There's a few Chinese ones. There's the Spider China ETF, gave a bearish reversal signal, and there's a few Indian ones, and there's a couple of NASDAQ ones. And so there's a theme there, and if we look at the China, the Spider China ETF, there's the bearish reversal signal. Notice that we've had a nice move up over the past couple of months, but the pros have not taken control. So a little confidence in the up move in the Chinese market, a little more confidence in the Indian market. But again, we have a bearish reversal signal here, potentially marking a top for this move for the Indian market. And last but not least, the 2X and the 3X ETFs for the NASDAQ both generated bearish reversal signals last week, and neither one has the pros taking control. So a little concern about the NASDAQ market from the pros right now. So that should be a concern for anybody who's in technology stocks. Last up for weekly charts, the natural gas ETF generated a buy signal last week. And I'm certainly going to take this buy signal. We took the buy signal here. It didn't last very long. We took the buy signal here. It only lasted a couple of weeks. We're going to take the buy signal here. And if it only lasts a couple of weeks, that's what it's doing. But if you're making money on the short side, you certainly don't want to be long this ETF now that it's generated a buy signal. We were looking for a close above 709. We closed at 728. That's all you need to know. There's no way we can guarantee that this is going to work out, but this is what it is, and it's time to go long natural gas, and we've certainly been talking about natural gas looking at the daily charts. Let's finish off this morning's presentation looking at a couple of daily charts. On Friday, we talked about some bearish reversal signals from Thursday's trading action. One of the most important ones was the Dow Jones Banking Index generated a bearish reversal signal on Thursday. We were looking for fall through to the downside on Friday or a breakout above Thursday's high to tell us that that signal was nullified. What we got was the market actually traded on Thursday as high as 312.37. On Friday, it also traded up to 312.37, so couldn't break through Thursday's high. So that bearish reversal signal is still in play. Now, Friday's trading action gave us a sell signal in the NASDAQ, and it was very stock specific. We're going through earnings season right now, and I'd be a lot more concerned if the Russell and the ZAX Microcap Index had followed suit, but it was really just the NASDAQ. So if you're long any of the NASDAQ ETFs, you should certainly check them. And of course, your individual stocks, you need to check those as well. Last up, looking at commodities, the GLD and the gold futures contract rolled over on Friday and generated a new sell signal, while silver held up fairly well. It was down 7 cents on Friday, but certainly no major panic in the silver market on Friday. It is just gold. And for whatever reason, I guess gold is more affected by what's going on in the currency market than silver is at this time. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. Nothing to get overly panicked about on the weekly charts. Things look pretty steady, but we are looking for a seasonal move down going into the end of April and going into May. And we're looking for that to start at any time. And it might be started by the technology sector with the NASDAQ rolling over, generating a sell signal on Friday. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again next on Tuesday morning.